In the first part of the video, we had seen the embryology of the palate. Now in part 2, we will go through the various classifications of cleft palate which are based on the embryology. A quick overview is that the palate is formed of the primary palate, which is developed from the premaxilla anterior to the incisive foramen, and the secondary palate, which is posterior to the incisive foramen, that forms by the palatine shells from the maxillary processes. It consists of the hard palate and the soft palate. The important thing to remember about the palatal fusion is that it occurs from anterior to posterior. So consider it like a zip, and it closes from anterior to the posterior part. That's why notching in the posterior part in the soft palate is more common as opposed to the complete clefts which can occur if there is a failure of fusion of the entire processes. The first classification is the Wu classification, which has four parts. That is, type 1 is involving the soft palate, 2 is for the soft and the hard palate, 3 is a complete unilateral cleft of the palate and the lip, and 4th is a complete bilateral one. There is another classification which is called the LaSalle classification. This classification moves from the lip to the alveolus, hard palate, soft palate, back from the hard palate, alveolus and lip. So basically right and left is added depending on which side is involved. One of the important classifications is the Kernan and Stark's striped Y classification. This represents the different parts that are involved in a cleft lip and palate. So this already has the denotations of right side and left side, and depending on which side is involved. So it's 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5 and 6 from above downward. This is all anterior to the incisive foramen. So it involves the lip or the alveolus and the primary palate. And posterior to the incisive foramen is the hard palate, 7 and 8, and 9 representing the soft palate. Millard further increased a few points and modified this classification, where triangles on either side, inverted and straight ones, are added to represent the nose and the nasal floor, and anterior to the incisive foramen also part of the palate as well as posterior to it. So there are a total of 11 points in that. An important Indian classification is a Nagpur classification, which was described by Professor C. Balakrishnan. It's a simple classification which has three groups in it. Group 1 is that of the lip alone. 1A would be involvement of the alveolus. 2 is of the palate. 2S is the submucous cleft palate. And 3 is a complete cleft of the lip and the palate. There is another classification used in India, which is the Professor Sawhney classification. So there are many such classifications which are available for describing cleft palate and whether there's an involvement of the cleft lip or not. But Kernan and Stark classification is definitely asked in the exam. So is the Wu classification. You get an entire short note to write on the various ones. So that's all about the embryology of the palate and the classifications that come from it.